रोलिंग
सिद्धार्थ भाई थोड़ा हाथ नीचे कर ले
रोलिंग किया आपने
हाथ कौन सा नीचे करना
हाँ बस वही जिस हाथ में पहना
चंदन जी रोलिंग
रोलिंग
नीचे मतलब
मतलब हल्का सा सेट रहेगा ज्यादा बेटर
ऐसे
ये
So, by the way, I met some guy at IIT Market.
Okay.
I was parking the car and he's looking at me and Ishtar, I'm like, I went like that to him. So then I went out of the car. He's like, bro, 420 grams. I'm like, yeah. He's like, bro, I love you guys and your show. You guys are so downright straight up. You know, like the way dudes talk. So keep at it. So just straight up, bro.
Dudes talking. Hello and welcome to a brand new episode of 420 Grams here on newsclick.in. I've got a long intro lined up because I've just learned that the way the YouTube algorithm works, guys, is that it promotes videos that get more engagement, so more likes and more comments. So before we get into anything further, please like and comment on this if you enjoy what we're doing on the show. Pichli baar humne bola tha hum Hindi mein bhi baat karenge, to koshish hai ki is baar bhi wo jari rahe. Hamare saath studio mein maujood hain aaj Anuj Gupta, a friend of the show.
Co-owner of Sudeva football club and owner of Xativa.
No, CD Olympic de Xativa.
CD Olympic de Xativa, which is the third division.
Yeah.
Spanish football club. Sir, maan gaye. Shakal dekh ke lagta nahi, par it's amazing.
Agar shakal dekh kar hi football khelna hota, to India bahut peeche hoti.
Ye baat sahi. That's a good one.
We're just having a talk downstairs by Tony Joseph on a book called Ugly Indians, which talks about the genetic. Actually, you'll be quite interested in it. Talks about the origins of basically the race that is Indians.
I would love to check it out.
Anyway, to get back to the intro, lots of shout outs today. Firstly, to Nikki Bandini, who used to be known as Paolo Bandini, the sports writer, covered football extensively, covered the Italian league, has come out as transgender. So, effectively becoming the first, I suppose, transgender football journalist around.
Hmm.
Yeah, so I for one, I mean, many of us would be delighted to have more inclusive press boxes at sports stadiums. So hopefully that works out.
And he's really good, man. It is
yeah,
good,
yeah.
Huh? Paolo Bandini.
Sure.
Bandini.
Not,
especially
yeah,
Serie A.
So Nikki Bandini.
Nikki Bandini. Okay.
And to Ishwak, who is still missing. It's been 2 weeks.
Hmm.
Today we've learned that the phone lines have opened up. So I've been trying to get in touch. We haven't spoken yet. But we will chat with Ishwak. So right before we get into the rest of the conversation for this show, we'll plug that in later whenever we get to have that chat with Ishwak. But Kashmir is still shut down, so our show is not going to Kashmir yet. Let's hope that opens up very, very soon.
I think it will. Pretty soon.
So. Hmm. Coming to the football, 25 days to go to India's first qualifier for the 2023 Asian Cup and the 2022 World Cup. Where are we at? What's happening? And Anuj, we'll come to you for sort of a perspective on how the national team is being fed in terms of grooming of talent, because that's what your expertise is.
Yeah, I think if you see in totality, football at the youth level is growing at an alarming rate. And the reason I say that is because...
Why do you say that?
Yeah, because at the moment there are three under 17 players of the World Cup who's in the national team, which is Amarjeet is there.
Hmm.
Gelot was in the team, but in the end, because of the injury, he had to leave.
Hmm.
But he's there.
No, Gelot is there. He played versus Serie A.
No.
Under 17 World Cup final.
Ha, ha.
And Anwar Ali.
Hmm.
So I think these three guys being in the national team says a lot that India is working towards getting the youth into the national team at a younger age, because in the longer run, these players would become the assets for the national team.
Yeah, and in the end, they've been scouted, they've come through a process. So in a way, you know, you're banking on them from a very early age on. And you're banking on them from a very early age saying that they will make it to the national team. It's not like, you know, you scouted them saying that you're scouting them for the under 17. You're scouting them for the national team from very early age.
Yeah, and secondly is because they are giving them the opportunity to play for the national team.
Mm.
Forgetting that the Indian team might not perform right now, but in the longer run, they will perform because the younger ones are getting a chance.
So let me flip that question to you. You've seen how the system works in Spain, where also you're running a youth academy and all of that, and the number of competitive matches, etc., etc., training hours that go into creating an international level football player. These boys who are going into the system from here, are they ready?
Are they getting enough game time?
Are they ready? Are they ready to play?
I think I already know the answer.
Are they? You think they are prepared to be getting a start and play 90 minutes at international level?
I mean, I think that no, they're still not ready. Why? Because if these kids were trained from a very early age, when I say very early age, it's about 8 years or 7 years old. Mm. From that age, if they would have got about 40 matches a season, by the time they would have been 18, they would have had about 500 matches. And that is where the difference lies. You know, it's not about getting them matches now. It's about getting matches from day one when they started football. And that is where I think, but it is growing at a good rate. But still, we're just pushing it to we're just expecting too much from these boys at this moment.
Bhai, aap ek batao. Pehli baat, jo log dekh rahe hain isko, CD Olympic de Xativa, jab aapne wo team kharidi, it's a third division team in Spanish. So, what is the hierarchy system in Spain?
So, okay, so there are...
Primera Liga, jo sab jante hain.
Yeah, yeah. There's La Liga.
La Liga.
There is La Liga 2, or it's called Segunda A. Then it is Segunda B, then it is Tercera, then it's Preferente, then it is Primera Regionale, then it is Segunda Regionale.
So, aap kahan pe ho?
We are at the Tercera level, it's third division, but it's the fourth tier.
So, matlab aapka ek senior team hai Tercera level.
Tercera level pe.
Uske alawa aapke paas kaun si
team hai? I have one more team which is at the sixth division. That's we call it the CD Olympic de Xativa B team. And then I have two under 19 team which is called the Juvenil. Juvenil is the under 19. And in Juvenil also, there are five divisions. So, you know, just to let you know that in every age category, you will at least find five divisions, four to five divisions.
No, so the reason I was asking
you... And this is the typical, structure of a club?
This is a typical structure of a club from the youth level to the senior league. At least they will have at least three to four teams at the youth level. And then at least they'll have one to two teams at the senior level.
No, so the point I was actually trying to get to is that what this entire system is and what you're kind of inheriting. And what you have now, and why it's not there in India. Is it because of finance? Is it because of cash that people in India can't replicate something like this? Because you have close to about 10-15 teams under your CD Olympic de Xativa, which is not just the senior teams,
yes,
junior level teams, A teams, B teams, C teams. Aisa apne desh mein hai nahi.
Yeah, I think one more reason is that this club is 1924 registered club. So we are in 2024, it'll be 100 years. You know, so it's not any other club, it's a very old club. So we need to also see that it takes time. You know, we cannot just say that it is happening in Spain, so it will happen in India also so quickly. But yes, main sabse ek hi cheez bolta hu ki agar kuch football ke liye karna hai, humko sabko sochna ek jaisa hai. Sochte hi nahi ek jaisa. You know, India is unique. We don't have to replicate any models. We have to create our own models. But we have to look at other models. That's important. And Spain is the right country in Europe also.
Why do you say this?
You see how he looks at the camera straight away?
Bro, he's set.
He's a natural.
He's on. why do you say Spain is the right
because
model for
I'll tell you why. Spain has over 20,000 clubs. Okay. For instance, Valencia is a state in is a province in Spain. There are over 100,000 registered players only in Valencia. Okay.
But bhai, wahan pe football ka chaska alag hai na. अपने देश में क्रिकेट का चस्का अलग है
यार क्रिकेट के अंदर भी ऐसी यूथ टीम्स हैं क्या इतनी यूथ
क्यों नहीं है भाई बहुत है यार
डू वी हैव दीस नेशनल लेवल लीग्स इन क्रिकेट नो
यू डोंट हैव नेशनल लेवल लीग्स इन क्रिकेट बट देयर इज अ सिस्टम इन प्लेस देयर इज अ लैडर इन प्लेस
अगर लोकली इतना कंपटीशन है स्टेट लेवल पे है
तो आईपीएल हटा दो अगर आईपीएल नहीं होता तो क्रिकेट का लेवल नहीं बढ़ा होता जितना बढ़ रहा है
नहीं यार
यू टेल मी आई मीन हाउ मेनी प्लेयर्स आर कमिंग फ्रॉम आईपीएल राइट
डिस्कशन में
ओके बट यार
नहीं भाई देखो जी क्रिकेट की जो बात है वो उनकी सही बात है कि उनके पास उनका सिस्टम है अपने पास फुटबॉल की बात
क्रिकेट हैज टेकन ओवर 50 टू 60 इयर्स इन दिस कंट्री टू मेक अ प्रेजेंस यू कांट से द क्रिकेट इज अ न्यू स्पोर्ट इट्स बीन प्लेइंग सिंस 1960s 1970s राइट
सो
या वी कैन नॉट कंपेयर इट फुटबॉल इट हैज स्टार्टेड इन द लास्ट 20 इयर्स नॉट इवन 20 इयर्स व्हेन पीपल हैव स्टार्टेड अंडरस्टैंडिंग फुटबॉल हैज स्टार्टेड कमिंग ऑन टीवी एंड यू स्टार्टेड वॉचिंग ईपीएल्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड इन द ला लीगा एंड दैट्स व्हाई वी थिंक दैट ओ That's the level we want to reach. But I'm sorry. If the TV was not there, we would have not thought what the level is. you know, and considering that, I mean, for instance, state associations, okay, the state associations in this country, in every state, there's a football association, okay, but are they working for the youth? No. We need to make sure that the state associations act as what AIFF does, creating a platform, not of someone who will get money also. I'm sorry, in Spain, the federation doesn't get money per se. The clubs have to give money. If I have youth teams, okay, I have to have money to take care of the away matches. I have to have money for the grounds. I have to have money for the team, for the coach, everything.
So, sir, you have here in Kolhapur, there is a club here. You have in Raipur, there is a club here. How can you expect them to have all that?
Why not? It's the same concept.
I would, yeah. And like, you do end up getting support from the local community also. There's so many stories of how these things happen.
So, their local community is a big part of it.
Like in Kolhapur also, I mean, or we saw, I mean, as you go up the leagues, it becomes more and more difficult. Like, the expenses involved in running a Tercera club versus running a Serie A club. Yeah. With each level, he knows how much it... You just have to add zeros to your budget, and adding zeros is, you know, it's not even, it's not that straightforward.
Well, for instance, the ISL club budget would be equal to a Secunda B budget.
Secunda B
is one level ahead above of us. Yeah, above us.
Third division.
Secunda B is third tier, Premier League.
No, this is fourth tier. Usko par Secunda B, which is third tier, but it's called the second division B. Then it is second division A, and then it is La Liga.
Then La Liga.
So, wo level hai. You know, and us level pe
can I ask you something? So clearly you're one level below Segunda B.
Mere hisab se to wo level nahi hai ISL ka. Kuch players ho sakte hain ISL mein jo us level ke hain.
Sir, main financial terms ki baat kar raha hu. Financial terms mein aap sirf ek level niche ho. To aapne ye paisa ISL mein kyun nahi socha aur aapne ye kyun socha ki main Spain mein jaake itna paisa?
Because I don't believe that I have to buy a club in India to reach ISL. I have a club in India called Sudeva FC, as you said. I want to take that club to ISL, but that is only possible when the system is very clear. When promotion relegation starts, whenever the I-League window opens, I would like to bid for I-League. If it happens this year, definitely I'm bidding it. Because
so
from Delhi,
you're not concerned about the sort of uncertainty?
No. Because India, to be honest, football is, that is not football, according to me.
What is not football?
That is entertainment.
The ISL.
ISL is entertainment. Football is what you see when you go to a ground and you see children playing football. We need to work on that.
Fist bump kar raha hai, sir.
Yeah. That is football. And in Spain, that is football. You have to come to a ground and see the support which the children get from their parent. On the weekend, they will come with the
But bro, the thing is, that's my point. Apna, dekho yaar, yahan pe Spain ki jo population hai, 80% population is after football. So the family,
yeah, everyone population
is involved,
wali baat nahi hai. Agar aap numbers ki baat karo, to Hindustan mein there are far bigger numbers of sheer numbers of definitely boys, and very soon there will be girls also playing the sport. So it's not a question of numbers. It never is here.
Yeah, but my point is, you're saying,
and it's always been like that. I mean, like in the Northeast, ab structure abhi aaya hai shayad, aur hame bhi abhi pata chala hai na thodi. Abhi bhi log kehte hain yaar, pata hi nahi. Acha, you fly to Imphal, wahan direct flight jaati hai.
Acha. Are you there in the Northeast for how long right now?
For a few weeks. But anyway, that's digressing.
No,
so,
but the point is,
that football, there are so many, every child is playing, on every ground, everywhere. And as you come into sort of middle India, it's replaced to some extent by cricket, for sure.
I think
football is still very much going on, and the numbers are there.
Yeah. And I literally travel all over the country to find talent, right? So when I go for a trial, I see a lot of numbers, and the numbers are increasing every year.
Could you define it for us, for all
like,
the people?
Like, for instance, you know, I won't talk about Northeast, because in India, everyone thinks that football is only played in Northeast, which is not true.
Which is not completely true.
Okay. So for instance, I went to, Udaipur. You know, I had about 200 kids. And I just put a post on the Facebook one day before the trial. 200 बच्चे आए
और उनमें से टैलेंट
आई थिंक द ओवरऑल टैलेंट वॉज गुड इनफ फॉर मी टू थिंक दैट यस
बट द फैक्ट कि 200 बच्चे आ गए एक दिन में
ना मतलब यार एवरी किड हु प्लेस फुटबॉल ही थिंक दैट ही वांट्स टू बी मेसी यू नो ही फील्स दैट यार आई एम अ प्लेयर राइट तो हम ये नहीं देख रहे कि टैलेंट कितना है हम ये देख रहे हैं कितना नंबर है ठीक है तो उदयपुर करा जयपुर करा आई मीन सोलन हिमाचल में यू नो इट्स अ बिग नंबर यार आई मीन मैंने वहां पर करा पिथौरागढ़ में
पिथौरागढ़
इट्स बिफोर मुंसियारी इन उत्तराखंड
ऑलमोस्ट इन नेपाल
आई मीन देयर अबाउट 200 प्लस 300 किड्स मतलब वो आ गए यार और कहां 6-6 घंटे की ट्रैवल करके आ रहे हैं यार वो आधे घंटे की ट्रायल के लिए वो बंदा 6 घंटे बस में आ रहा है इजंट इट फुटबॉल आई थिंक दैट इज फुटबॉल वी नीड टू कैप्चर ऑल दैट एंड रियली गिव देम अ सिस्टम ऑफ ऑनेस्टी या बिलीफ कि इंडिया कैन प्रोड्यूस फुटबॉलर्स यार और वो आइसलैंड बनाकर होगा
so, हाँ मतलब वो तो यो आप एलीट लेवल पे तो जो मर्जी कर लो वो तो आप लोग कर ही रहे हो बट आई थिंक एन इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग अबाउट द नंबर्स इज दैट बेसिकली देयर इज समथिंग अबाउट दिस स्पोर्ट दैट कीप्स दैट इज एंगेजिंग फॉर पीपल दैट इवन इन डिफिकल्ट टाइम्स देयर इज ऑलवेज फुटबॉल सो गेटिंग मोर पीपल टू प्ले द गेम इरिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ वेदर योर नेशनल टीम बिकम्स लाइक आइसलैंड और नॉट In any case, India and Iceland are not comparable at any level.
Oh, no, no,
मतलब
no.
जब मैं कह रहा हूँ हाँ मैं eventually
मैं उस तरीके से बोल रहा हूँ कि आइसलैंड में अगर 3 लाख की पॉपुलेशन है ठीक है हमें भी इंडिया को 140 करोड़ क्या जो भी है हमको पॉपुलेशन के हिसाब से नहीं सोचना है हमें ये सोचना है कि जो फुटबॉल खेल रहे हैं वो अगर 50 लाख लोग भी हैं कैन वी रियली वर्क ऑन those 50 lakhs You know, I mean, are we giving them
That's
the right
5 million people, yeah.
5 million people is huge, man.
And I'm sure the numbers are actually much, much bigger.
Much more bigger than that.
Much bigger.
No, so the aim is, like you know, whenever you're talking football, the aim for an Indian footballer or you know, the mark for any Indian footballer is whether he can make it to Europe or not.
Yeah.
Now, you have two Indian boys who have joined Xativa from when?
Last year.
So, how many months?
So they joined in October last year.
And which is now we're talking in almost August.
9-10 months, yeah.
Ten months. 10 months back. And now they've made the first team.
Yes.
Of Xativa.
Yes.
Which means they will be playing the Tercera level
yes.
of Spain.
So of Spain.
And they made it on their merit.
Absolutely.
They joined on which team? When they
joined in an under-19 team of Olympic.
Under-19.
In last year.
A team.
Yeah.
Main team.
Under-19 main team. Yeah, and
they had a trial for that. The coach saw them and everything.
The coaches came here to take the trial. They selected them and then they went there.
Okay.
And they played last year under 19 and they were training with the first team and playing for the under 19.
So they've trained regularly?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and then this year the coach thought that, yeah, they should be given chance. And both of them are 19 years. You know,
so 19 year old boys are playing the Tercera level.
I mean, yeah.
And there's a chance they might play Copa del Rey and everything. And Spanish Super Cup.
Not this year because Tercera teams don't play.
Okay.
Secunda B and ahead, above, they play Copa del Rey. If you win the Tercera level, then next year we'll play Copa del Rey. That's the rule.
How did you do in the league last year?
We lost in the playoffs.
Playoffs for Secunda B.
For the Secunda B. Which was, you know, good enough, I think. But yeah, and
no, but I want to know about these kids.
So
yeah.
Are you're among the favorites, obviously?
Yeah, because see, in Tercera, Olympic has been always that club which is kind of a Secunda B club.
Mm-hmm. They but make playing below.
Playing below. Mm-hmm. So we've always been a second division club, mm-hmm. but we got relegated, and that's where you know we always try to make a team which can go up. So the level of the team has to be Secunda B, then only you can think of promoting.
No, so on the basis of these two kids,
yeah.
So you know, we always think that Indian kids can't play in Europe.
Yeah.
Or if they go to play in Europe, they're playing some 9th division or 8th division
yeah.
in Europe, you know, so they call it Europe. But you've seen the rise of these two boys. Has it been an easy rise? Has it been a gradual rise? Has it been something that you've had to do from your end? That has helped them get to where they are right now, or just pure talent, and they've slowly moved up the ranks.
Well, these two boys have been there in Sudeva from day one, which has been about 4 years since 1 year in Spain and about 4 years before, so about four and a half years. You know, we've been training them, and now I really feel proud of them that this is the moment when they get a chance to play in Spain at that level where the captain of the team is ex-Real Madrid. So the captain of our team has played for Real Madrid. So, you know, you're playing with that kind of players who played for this ex-Barcelona player, Real Madrid, Valencia. So in that level of player, these boys are playing at the age of 19. So that's where I wanted to prove that take them at the right age and these boys are ready. They will get ready. And it is not difficult.
But it's all about putting them in that environment.
Environment. And to be honest, language is the issue. To be honest. More than the level of the game, it's also the communication. Because, you know, at football is about communication, right? At that level. So I think with time, once they get the hold of the language as well, that will also really help. But the Spanish mentality is, at least I can say of Xativa, and the people there, they've started looking India as a market where they would like to explore for Indian talent, which is fantastic, right? And that was the reason I thought that.
हजारों सालों से हिंदुस्तान हैज बीन अ मार्केट फॉर पीपल टू एक्सप्लोर फॉर ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ थिंग्स
भाई फुटबॉल में यार कब 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 सुना है ये
क्या एक चीज है असलियत हां जो फुटबॉल में है जो बाकी लाइफ में नहीं है यार सारा द होल स्टोरी कैन बी बॉइल्ड डाउन टू
सर आप सिमिलैरिटीज फिलोसॉफिकल लेवल पे जा रहे हो मैं फुटबॉल की बात कर रहा हूं कि पिछले 10 साल में आपने क्या सुना है कौन यूरोप जा रहा है आपने सुनील छेत्री की बात सुनी है वो गया और वो एमएलएस में गया वो यूरोप में गया पोर्चुगल में गया
द डिफरेंस इज वेरी स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड मैन
खेलने को नहीं मिला था
नहीं माय पॉइंट इज इफ यू वांट टू फाइंड अ रूट टू गो टू यूरोप
बट द पॉइंट इज दैट लाइक ही सेड एंड इट्स एज मच अ सॉर्ट ऑफ जस्टिफिकेशन लाइक अ छाप ऑन द फिलॉसफी द क्वाइट देसी फिलॉसफी दैट हकारी एंड अनुज हैव एम्प्लॉयड इन एट सुदेवा they've not come with koi diploma nahi leke aaye hain ya ye sab but apne ideas leke aaye hain aur usi basis pe inhone teams banayi hain aur in bachchon ko sikhana football whatever shuru kiya hai so it's remarkable that with that sort of background ye log jaake aise system mein fit ho sakte hain and agar khelne ko milega to kitne game khelenge season mein
38 matches hote hain before the playoffs If you go into playoff, then it is two matches.
So what are the coach telling you that these boys have a chance of making the first team? Like they have a chance to play regular or be a part of the first team? 30-man squad, 24-man
squad.
No, so
basically every team has a restriction of 22 licenses, okay, which is called features in Spain. So these two boys will be getting the first team features. So that was the first major hurdle. Okay, now the second hurdle would...
So because they are under 19, they get some... Is there some relaxation?
No, so under 23 is the rule.
Yeah.
So six players have to be under 23.
So they are part of that 6-23. Yeah.
So now...
Otherwise, they will be competing for the foreign players' spots, which is... I guess
no, in Tercera, I think the restriction is not there.
Okay.
And, I mean, that is also a good thing about this level, that, you know, under 23 ka bhi hai, foreign ka bhi itna nahi hai. So it's a fantastic level for a lot of Indians to think about. बट मुझे एक चीज लगती है कि जब बच्चा अच्छा खेलता है ना यहाँ पे तो वो उसको ना ठीक है मैंने सुना है कि 18-19 साल के लड़कों को अच्छे कॉन्ट्रैक्ट मिल रहे हैं और सैलरीज ठीक मिल रही हैं
सर ठीक तनख्वाह मिल रही है
पर यार तनख्वाह
50 लाख रुपए मिल रहे हैं साल के
यार बट उस 50 लाख से हम टैलेंट को खत्म कर रहे हैं
कहाँ खत्म कर रहे हो यार यार लड़का पैसे कमाने के लिए खेलता है
नहीं यार आपको टैलेंट को नर्चर करना जरूरी है आपको कितने मिनट दे रहे हो गेम के अंदर वो इम्पोर्टेंट है ठीक है टैलेंट
तो आपके स्पेन के हिसाब से कितने मिनट मिलने चाहिए
40 मैच लगा लो ऑन एवरेज तो 3500 मिनट होते हैं ठीक है सीजन में अब 3500 मिनट के अंदर यार 1000-1500 मिनट तो मिले जब पता लगेगा ना वही वो अब यहाँ पर भी 20 मैच होते हैं मेरे ख्याल से आईएसएल
यहाँ पे तो टॉप लेवल प्लेयर्स को 1500 मिनट मिलते
हैं
हाँ मुश्किल से
20 मैच होते हैं ना मेरे ख्याल से
20 मैच
तो 20 × 90 हाँ 1800 मिनट हो गया हाँ तो 1800 मिनट हो गया अब 1800 मिनट में जो सारे मैचेस खेल रहे हैं उसको 1800 मिल रहे हैं तो मेरा पॉइंट ये है कि ठीक है बट क्या वो 10-15-20 प्लेयर ही हैं क्या प्लेयर्स तो यार
मतलब माय स्टैंड ऑन दिस इज
नो सो हाउ आर दीस बॉयज इंटीग्रेटिंग विद द टीम एंड
नो
यू नो फॉर ऑल
हां मतलब दे स्टार्टेड लर्निंग फ्रॉम लास्ट ईयर एंड हां मतलब उनको मैंने बोला था कि यार ऐसा है कि फुटबॉल में जो तुम अपनी लैंग्वेज में बोलते हो वो तुम स्पैनिश में सीखो ठीक है, जो कोच बोल रहा है वो समझो, ठीक है, और हाँ वो उससे शुरू करो, बिकॉज दैट विल बी एक्साइटिंग फॉर यू टू लर्न. और आई थिंक मैं पोजिशंस तो नहीं बता सकता अभी, आई थिंक इट्स बिकॉज वो जब वो मोमेंट आएगा देन इट शुड बी बेटर फॉर देम ऑल्सो. एंड बोथ द पोजिशंस आर क्रिटिकल क्रिटिकल पोजिशंस.
अमेजिंग मान, लाइक
एक रोकता है और एक बनाता है.
नाम भी बता ही दे.
नहीं, नहीं,
बाकी सब तो बोल ही दिया है.
लाइक
हाउ हार्ड इज इट टू फिगर आउट, गिवन दैट ही इज टॉक्ड अबाउट दीस बॉयज ऑन दिस शो बिफोर, हाउ हार्ड इज इट टू फिगर आउट नाउ हु द गाइस आर.
भाई माय पॉइंट इज अ मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द पीपल हु वॉच द शो आर ऑल यंग किड्स, राइट? 15-20-25 सर ये है हमारी डेमोग्राफिक. 10-15-20-25 और 10-15-20-25 में अक्सर यही सोच है कि ISL तो छोड़ो, यूरोप जाने के लिए तो मतलब क्या पापड़ बेलने पड़ेंगे. पापड़ बेलने पड़ेंगे क्या?
100%
कितने पापड़ बेलने पड़ेंगे?
कुछ नहीं
नहीं तो जो ये इतने सारे लोग आपको कहते हैं कि हम 2 हफ्ते के लिए आपको लेके जाएंगे, 3 हफ्ते के लिए आपको लेके जाएंगे, उससे क्या होने वाला है?
कुछ नहीं होने वाला, कुछ नहीं होने वाला. बस ये है कि वो स्टेडियम दिखा देंगे, स्टेडियम की टिकट कट जाएगी, वहाँ पे एक टूर हो जाएगा, एक वो कोई लाली का मैच दिखा देंगे, 3-4 दिन
मार्केटिंग हो गया.
मार्केटिंग हो गया, बट ठीक है, इट्स अ ट्रिप. इट इज नॉट अ ट्रिप वेयर द किड वुड नो वेदर ही वॉन्ट्स टू कम बैक और नॉट. इट्स अ ट्रिप वेयर इट्स अ टिक मार्क, यार हमें गया था.
आई विल कम टू द पॉइंट, डजंट इंडियन प्लेयर हैव इट इन हिमसेल्फ और हरसेल्फ टू प्ले इन यूरोप, नॉट एट द हाईएस्ट लेवल बट टू स्टार्ट एट द लोएस्ट लेवल and then to work his way up. That is my point.
200%.
And what is the right age to do it then?
I think the right age, see, there are certain laws which are against international players in Europe. One is that obviously you have to be 18 to be registered as a player.
So after 18 you have to come?
No. But there are certain elements where you can be registered before 18, but for that you have to be there for a couple of years. Okay, to get registered, the good thing is that you get to play the federation leagues. But if you're not registered, then you play friendlies. Friendly, there's no promotion relegation, there's no worry of losing. So obviously, yeah, jab wo nahi hota
intensity,
na, intensity kam ho jati hai. But still, for instance, if I talk about under-15, under-15 mein 4 divisions hai, theek hai. Pehli hai Liga Autonomica, fir Preferente, aise aise karke hai.
So, Spanish has become damn good, huh? accent.
So under-15 ki top division ke andar, you have all the La Liga teams. Okay. And abhi jo Spanish coaches aaye the, main batata hu, thoda main kar raha hu. They selected 2 kids. They, according to them, they think that they are ready to play in the top division of under-15. Isn't it a great news?
Why do they feel so? Because they have technical skills or everything?
Both. Everything. Character, technical skills, fitness, everything.
Could you specify? So when a coach of yours comes from Spain to look out for talent, what is he looking for?
First,
and be specific.
Yeah. First is mind. Theek hai? Intelligence is the key, because that is something which would develop him as a player the fastest. Second is technique. थर्ड इज फिटनेस. ठीक है, तो पहला दिमाग, सेकेंड टेक्निक, थर्ड इज फिटनेस. फिटनेस इज नेवर द फर्स्ट, फिटनेस बन जाती है. ठीक है, एंड यंगर यू आर, इट्स नॉट अ रॉकेट साइंस है. तुम 12 साल का बच्चा दे दो, वो ऑब्वियसली ही विल लर्न एवरीथिंग फास्टर. तुम 17 साल का बच्चा दोगे, वो उसको उतना ही प्रॉब्लम होगी, राइट? सो सिंपल है. दे सेड under-13 लेवल वॉज द बेस्ट, देन इट वॉज 15, देन इट वॉज 18, एंड under-23 वॉज हॉरिबल.
And this is horrible.
Yeah, and this is the case in India. As you grow older, बहुत सारी problems आ जाती हैं. वो तो छोड़ यार, 12वीं खत्म कर, तू college में जा.
खेलते ही नहीं हैं. और क्या problem क्या है?
Regularly नहीं खेलते ना भाई. ठीक है. Competition game खत्म हो जाती है.
So I would say under-15 में the kids has to be in Spain. 13-14 साल में ले जाओ. Guarantee है, मैं अभी कह रहा हूँ कैमरे पे. ठीक है ना? 4 साल के अंदर यही लड़के वहाँ पे टॉप डिविजन में खेल रहे होंगे under-19 में. ठीक है, विच इज फैंटास्टिक. लाइक एक लड़का ले गया था लास्ट, अभी भी है वो. ही प्लेड इन द सेकंड डिविजन ऑफ under-19. ही प्लेड अगेंस्ट वैलेंसिया under-19, लेवांते under-19.
सो वेयर इज ही नाउ?
ही इज विद अस ओनली. ही इज आल्सो ट्राइंग टू गेट इनटू द फर्स्ट टीम.
Xativa.
हाँ. सो आई एम जस्ट सेइंग दैट, एंड ही परफॉर्म्ड वेल, ही गॉट लॉट ऑफ मिनट्स लास्ट ईयर इन under-19 सेकंड डिविजन. So, वो भी कोई इंडियन नहीं खेला अभी तक.
And have any of these boys got calls from the federation asking about them, what they're doing and all?
नहीं यार अभी तक तो, I mean, I don't want to say much about the federation, but I think the minutes are important, you know. And I'm someone who wants to wait. Let them get the minutes. Let them prove a point. You know, I don't believe in tick mark. कि यार ठीक है license मिल गया minutes तो मिले नहीं तो फायदा क्या हुआ? Let them get the minutes on the ground. And then definitely, you know, but I don't want them to come back, you know, because I want them to, keep on dreaming. Yeah? I mean, you want to play La Liga?
I mean, like, it's amazing, man. It's like one of those rare, it happens, one in a, I don't know how many thousand, where at least some, to some extent, it's like that movie, yeah, goal wali picture, jo sabne dekhi hui hai.
Shit movie.
Haan, from whatever, but like, it's guy from across North America who comes to Europe and tries to play football. India is like, a few generations behind North America also.
Yeah.
From here for these boys to be there, and when they get on the pitch, if hopefully they get to.
No, they will. And I'm 100% sure that
Before we end this, how can kids connect? Because see, the whole point is, when you want to go to Europe, you want to know what is the chain that gets you there. You have somewhat or the other developed a chain. Ki Sudeva hai, Xativa hai. So how does one connect and get into that?
Yeah, I think easiest is call me. Yeah. No, but otherwise, it's very important for any kid who's playing in India and he wants to play in Europe. Please, first see the club team where they are playing in their youth level. So that club might be a La Liga club, but are they giving you a chance to play in some category? Are they getting you the license to play? That is very important.
Like I recently read of this Nagaland kid from Nagaland who's playing 8th division or 7th division in Sweden. He signed for a 7th division team in Sweden.
Come on, man.
Wrap this up, guys. We've been at it for 40 minutes and it's going live.
So no, I mean...
Okay. I think we'll let you have the last word and then we'll say goodbye because...
Guys, if you watch football on TV, dare to dream that you can be on the TV. For that, you have to take that call and... don't stop dreaming, yeah. It's not that difficult, man. Just because they're coming on the TV doesn't mean that you can't.
I think key is not that difficult, man.
Yeah, it's not difficult.
हमें लगता है बहुत difficult है
यार.
पर actually मैं जो 13 साल 12 साल का बच्चा है, उसके पास avenues बहुत हैं यार.
This year, there's one kid I'm taking, who will get a trial in the top division under 15 in one of the La Liga clubs because they want to see him. So you know, if he gets in, I mean, these are the eye openers for international football. To see about India, a normal kid who's not even playing for the country in India, his level is good enough to play in the top division in a youth level. Isn't it a big thing here? And that is where I talk to the federation. That please,
thank you, Indian bumper music. Thank you guys for watching. See you next week.